A judge tells a prisoner that he will be executed at noon, someday between Monday and Friday. But he won't be told the exact day, so that he will be unpleasantly surprised when they knock at his door to pick him up. The prisoner deducts, "They cannot execute me on Friday. Why? If I am still alive after Thursday noon, then I would know that they will come for me the next day. I won't be surprised when they knock at my door. Hence, they need to kill me between Monday and Thursday. If that is the case, then they cannot kill me on Thursday either, because I would know by Wednesday noon and not be surprised. So it can't be Thursday." He follows through with that logic and realizes that if they want to surprise him, then there is actually no day of the week that they can execute him. When he was executed on Wednesday, he was completely surprised. Where was the flaw in the prisoner's logic? And if there is none, then how come that the judge was able to hold his promise and surprise him, even though the prisoner deducted that this would be impossible? This age-old philosophical conundrum is called the unexpected hanging paradox, and it hasn't officially been resolved until this day. Academia just can't agree on what the correct solution is, a situation which in itself has been called a meta-paradox. That's why philosophical, logical, and mathematical discussions about the unexpected hanging paradox just keep going. One proposed solution by the logical school suggests that the statement of the judge is self-contradictory. Imagine the paradox as the following card game. There are 5 cards face down on the table. They will be turned around one by one and you need to guess whether the next card is a jack. The dealer tells you 2 things. First, one and only one of those 5 cards is a jack. Second, you will never be able to tell with complete certainty that the next card will be the jack. You will quickly realize, like the prisoner did, that in a situation with only one option left, you would in fact know with 100% certainty that the next card must be the jack. At this point, one of 2 things will happen. Either the last card is indeed a jack and the dealer lied about his second statement, or the last card is not a jack, which makes the dealer's first statement a lie. Both can't be right. This Schrödinger's cat situation breaks down the game at the very last card. Since the dealer's initial 2 statements become self-contradictory, any deductions drawn from them are completely pointless. Don't do it. The dealer does not lie throughout the game though. One of his statements only becomes a lie should we ever reach the end. He creates an impossible situation for the last card, which is not a problem if we never get there. Imagine the game being played with 100 cards. You know that it will break down at the very end, but the dealer left enough room for himself to surprise you well before that point. Going back to the judge and the prisoner, it's the same thing. As long as the prisoner is hanged by Thursday, the judge will have stayed true to both his statements. And because they become self-contradictory for the very last day, deducing anything from that point is not legitimate. This is one way to look at the unexpected hanging paradox. But since there is no consensus yet, you should ask yourself, what do you think? The story goes that Bertrand Russell mentioned in one of his lectures that, given a contradictory starting point, one could deduce anything. A student raised his hand and said, "In that case, given that 1 = 0, prove that you're the Pope." Russell replied, "If 1 = 0, then add 1 to each side and you get 2 = 1. The Pope and I are 2 men. Given that 2 = 1, the Pope and I are 1 man. I am the Pope."